of more than 1 million. It was considered by many journalists as second only to the New York Times as the best newspaper in the nation. Encouraged by the conservative wing of the Chandler family, Times Mirror corporate management had Tom Johnson removed as publisher. Privately, Johnson expressed disappointment in Otis Chandler for not coming to his defense.
I mean, there was about Otis this feeling that probably no one could measure up to what he had done. And if he wasn't going to be able to hold on to it for whatever reason, then it would all go to pieces. And let it go.
Morale in the newsroom plummeted with the perception that corporate and family demands for higher profits, not quality journalism, came first. In one decade, the Times had four publishers, as many as it did during its first century. The paper and the Times Mirror Company suffered. In 1993, Otis Chandler's second son, Harry, took a job at the Times exploring the emerging nexus of personal computers, newspapers, and the internet. This Harry Chandler appeared equipped to help guide the Times into a new century. In a Christmas card, his father expressed support of Harry's dynastic ambitions.
Now, I have a son to carry on my life's work. This was the one area of my life that was not fulfilled, and I have been quite depressed by this reality. So onward and upward, Dad.
But his father made no active effort to help his son, whose prospects were also hampered by a 1996 Vanity Fair article. A now reclusive Otis Chandler unloaded years of anger and frustration towards his relatives.
He was pitted against this nefarious group of family members, nefarious and anonymous. No one ever saw them, no one ever saw their pictures. They were just sort of lurking somewhere in the distance, these malign influences, right-wing, intolerant, xenophobic people.
The article quoted Otis saying, "The Chandlers are elitists. They get bored with the problems of AIDS and the homeless and drive-by shootings. They want to ignore them and turn the clock back." He called his relatives self-indulgent coupon clippers, waiting for their next dividend check.
I remember the coupon clipper thing, and I remember thinking, gee, you know, he just doesn't know what he's talking about. I was doing very well, thank you, Otis, and didn't need it.
I was surprised at how forthcoming Otis was, and I think in a way he didn't really realize how it was going to be received.
Nearing the age of 70, Otis Chandler was every bit the family pariah that his 95-year-old mother had become decades before.
She has been treated almost as royalty in the last 10 or 15 years since her achievements have been recognized. In a way, it's deserving, and in a way, it's unfortunate, because she is not a queen by birth or by ascent.
She wouldn't go out, people would want to take her out for a drive. Nope, don't want that. And men have called to take her out to dinner. Nope, didn't want to go out to dinner. She just wouldn't go out.
And she waved her hand around her bedroom and said, "I have everything I need right here." And that was her view of her life for that last 15 years.
Dorothy Chandler, who helped transform Los Angeles from a provincial community to a modern city, died on July 6, 1997. She was 96 years old. In the final decade of her life, she never left her second-story bedroom.
There was no memorial at her pavilion for her. And I couldn't understand how her children didn't want that. I was never given an explanation. I would have canceled everything in Europe to come and conduct her memorial at her pavilion with her seat empty.
the same month that Dorothy Chandler died, the family board approved the sale of its stake in the Tejon Ranch, thus dismantling a piece of its heritage, much to the chagrin of Otis Chandler.
I think it was the last legacy from all the many properties that Harry Chandler and General Otis had bought. It was a real generational thing, though. You know, we were very fortunate to have, you know, my grandfather and my father have that as a place to kind of experience the great outdoors and sort of rites of passage, you know, the freedom that a big ranch can offer.
I do recall this, that Norman Chandler said to me, "Tom, you should know that this is a company that because of the trust and the way in which the company is structured will never be sold."
Los Angeles residents awakened Tuesday with the knowledge that their hometown paper is being taken over by out-of-towners. The Chicago-based Tribune Company is buying the Times Mirror Company. For more than 100 years, the Chandlers have kept the LA Times in the family. But in recent years, they've witnessed falling profits, layoffs, and a drop in worker morale.
Los Angeles would become the largest city in the United States without a locally owned metropolitan daily newspaper.
Jennifer Author, CNN, Los Angeles.
You don't use words like loyalty or betrayal when you're describing Chandlers any more than you would use them describing wolves or wild dogs. It's in their nature to eat. They consume. Ultimately, they had no sense of responsibility to this city or this region, which had made them all so wealthy.
Yeah, I guess I was the one that told him. He wasn't on our Chandler committee, so he didn't know. So I was the one that called him in the morning. He'd heard kind of rumors, but I guess I was the one. He didn't seem that upset, but understandably was shocked, I'm sure. But that wasn't easy for either of us.
Four years after the sale of the family business, Otis Chandler developed a rare neurological disorder that would slowly claim his life. He died at his California ranch on February 27, 2006. He was 78 years old. Some of his relatives elected not to attend the funeral.
"The best. No words better describe Otis Chandler than those two. Let's be the best," was the goal that Otis conveyed to his family and to those of us who worked with him throughout the years.
Though Otis Chandler had retreated from public life decades before, hundreds appeared to pay their respects to the man and his legacy, a legacy he had built upon from generations past.
Just as Harrison Gray Otis used his newspaper to promote the rise of Los Angeles from basically a remote Western town to an important American metropolis, Otis Chandler, during his watch on the Los Angeles Times, helped Los Angeles move towards international prominence, helped it become a world city.
One of the most compelling things about Harry Chandler, and Otis does this as well, but Chandler does it better, they cast their sights on the future of this region 100 years in advance of their own time, to our period, now. And in the process, they become extremely wealthy and extremely powerful. But in many respects, we have inherited part of the city that they envisioned and through their infrastructural and cultural pursuits that they built.
Whether by his own design, forces he could no longer control, or both, the family publishing dynasty ended with Otis Chandler. His departure would also mark the inexorable decline of the medium itself.
You kind of think of a newspaper, I always have anyway, as a person with a personality and predilections and strengths and weaknesses, and you play to your strengths, which I thought was explaining to people what the devil is happening in the world as best we possibly could.
I think that people underappreciate how much collective human intelligence and effort goes into the distillation that a newspaper represents of where we are in the world as of this moment.
I think Harry Chandler, Norman Chandler, my dad, Harrison Gray Otis, would really have been disappointed. Not because the family board didn't make a economically correct decision to diversify and to get out of what is an unattractive business today, but newspapers are much more than just a business. You know, they're really a lifeblood of a community, and to exit it, take your money just so you can increase your dividends, to me, was a real shame.
In the conduct of the Times, always place the true interests of the community before mere commercialism or financial success. We have here an exceptional city, and it is a proud and grateful task to serve such a people and help build up such a land. Harrison Gray Otis.
To learn more about Los Angeles, the Chandlers, and the newspaper industry, log on to pbs.org. Inventing LA, The Chandlers and Their Times is available on DVD. To order, call PBS Home Video at 1-800-PLAY-PBS or visit us online at shoppbs.org.